All right, we're inside and we're gonna tie some hair jigs. And you'd think, you know, you'd start with this stuff, bobbin, thread, head cement. Actually, no. We're starting with duct tape and this stuff. This is that stuff, these little iron-on patches that, you know, when you were a kid and you wore through the knee of your blue jeans. Yeah, your mom would dork it on up with a iron-on patch and get a little bit more mileage. That's what we're starting with, duct tape and iron-on patch. You take the, and this is what makes it the strap. You cut these narrow strips of the iron-on patch material. And as you get down towards the end, I try to cut it at an angle. The reason for that is we're gonna have to shove that through the hole in our walking weights. So take that, shove it in there. Pull that sucker down to the end, and I don't know, you leave half an inch, if that, less than half an inch, about that much, and you snip it off and you repeat, and you make a whole bunch of these. That's the first step. Before we move on, real quick word on where to get this stuff. And that's what it's called, twill patches. Walmart. Go to the sewing section of Walmart. I've also bought them in, I guess, the laundry detergent aisle in the grocery store, where they sell bleach and actually the same like RIT clothing dye that I've used to dye bucktails and stuff like that. But that's the aisle that you're looking for in the grocery store. Now we're ready for the duct tape, and I got some nice pretty blue stuff here. And these little guys, the glass rattles. We're gonna have a hair jig that rattles, really calls them in. What I'm using here are the XPS Bass Pro Shop ones. I've also got them at a tackle shop in Pennsylvania. Called Hoghead Baits. They sell them as well. There's a bunch of places you can get the stuff. So you take the duct tape, and basically you want a strip that is long enough or wide enough to encapsulate the tail end of the walking weight and the glass rattle. And I'll just stick that glass rattle right on the end there. And all I'm doing, just like I'm rolling a cigarette or something, just wrapping that around there. And that's the body. That's the body of the crayfish that will become the rattle, or the strap jig. Next thing we're using is foam. This is the foam body. You can get this stuff at a craft store, at Michael's or someplace like that. Very inexpensive. And you cut them into strips. I got a strip right here. And this is gonna be the body of the crayfish. So I want the crayfish to be about that long. And the crayfish sort of has a pointy beak, and that's gonna go back here on the body. That's gonna go right over there, and this is a little bit wide. I like to trim this just because I want the leading edge of this whole thing to be narrow as it's coming through the rocks. So I'm gonna trim that a little bit there, and you know, that's roughly a crayfish shell shape, and that'll go on there like that. Next, I'm gonna get my Zonker strips. This is black. You can do brown, I've done blue, green, there's all kinds of Zonker strip colors. You can also cut your own, but I'm not doing that today. And we're gonna cut the crayfish claws. So I'm gonna cut, and usually I'll cut a pile of these things and just have them ready. Every one of these steps, I do a lot of something, and then I have a pile, and then I just process. But for the purposes of showing you guys, there are my two little crayfish claws. So they're ready. And I will also get some of this stuff, round rubber. Great, great stuff. And you can combine, just like we Confidence Baits do with our finesse jigs, combine some silicone. I got some black with blue flake there. So we're gonna use a little bit of both of those. But we got the stuff ready. And we'll go ahead and start tying this. Now we get to the traditional tools of the trade. So you take this, the strap, and you have to secure this first and foremost, because this is gonna be where the business end of the strap jig happens. We're eventually gonna be putting a little octopus hook through both straps. So what you wanna do first is I'm just wrapping that around to get that sucker started. It's making a nice rattling sound as I'm doing that. I'll trim it. All right, now that that's started, I'm gonna go above the weight and really just kinda tighten that down so that strap's not, it's not sliding one way or another. Also go down to the body and just kinda tighten around the duct tape that's on both the rattle and the weight. I like to use size D thread because it's tough. All right, now we're ready for the foam body. And we'll start up here at the narrow end, which is the leading end of the crayfish, which is gonna be kinda scooting backwards. And I'm just giving a couple turns on that just to attach that, you know, that top foam body part of it. Then I'm gonna move down to the midsection. And it's really kinda gonna make a nice segmented body kinda shape to that. And then I'll go down here towards where everything's gonna attach. I'm gonna put these little tufts of a rabbit. Put one on each side. These are our claws. Oh yeah, starting to take form. I'm gonna angle that up a little bit more. I want those claws to come up. That's better. And then we got the round rubber, which is our, these are our crayfish antenna. The round rubber is nice and buoyant, and it'll lift up off the bottom. Even in the muddiest water, like what we had yesterday, muddy, 34, 35 degree water. These fish down there at the bottom, and there's no light penetration down there. How are they finding this thing? Two things, the rattle, and they're their lateral line picking up on things like this round rubber that lifts up off the bottom like that. So those are our crayfish antenna with claws. And now, if we want to bulk up this profile, we're going to go back up to the top, up to where we started. And we're just going to do, I don't know, half of a skirt layer. That's all we're going to do. I don't need much. These will kind of waver in current, and these will be the crayfish claws. Or not the claws, the legs underneath the body. Also gives a little bit of texture to add some scent. You don't want to add the scent near the hair at all. That's it. A couple of half hitches, head cement. Get that on there. Head cement up near the claws. Trim off that skirt layer. And I gotta separate the round rubber. And you can add round rubber to the body as well. You know, anywhere you put it, it's gonna have a nice subtle lifting up off the bottom. But that's our strap jig. It's missing one very crucial thing at this point. I'm gonna trim this up just a little bit so that when we add that octopus hook, it'll be good. All right, that's the key right there. This tiny little octopus hook. This is a number 4. It's a Matsuo Sickle Octopus hook, and you can get them for dirt cheap at a place called Captain Hook's Discount Hook Warehouse. Matsuo Sickle number 4 octopus. These are great for nose hook and Senkos too. Little 3-inchers all summer long. All right, all I'm doing is poking it right through the center of that, kind of fold it over, and tough stuff. There it goes. That way, when that fish grabs it, the leading edge, there's no piece of lead out in front of it to slow it down in its jaw. It grabs it, gets even the slightest bit of pressure, and wow, is that sticky. Sticky little hook. And that's what makes it work. Strap jig, number 4 sickle octopus hook. Catch them in low 30s water temperature on the strap jig. In a real quick summary, you start by pouring a whole lot of these walking weights. Then you trim them and get the twill patches and run them through the hole. Then you duct tape on the glass rattle. Then you cut up some of your zonker strips into the claws here. And you get your foam body on there, tie that on, put on your zonker strips, then your round rubber for the antenna, and if you'd like, a silicone skirt. And that's the end result. Having the hook leading keeps it out of trouble. Each time the bait stops, the round rubber lifts up, and the crayfish claws spread.